Now, your experience of Alfred Hitchcock hasn't been particularly brilliant, has it?
No.
The Birds is a bit dated.
Yes. So
Psycho isn't as scary as it was in its day. I think the thing with Hitchcock films is you have to remember when they were made and for what.
Yeah, no,
audience.
No, I know.
No, I mean, I think you're right there. But looked at cold, The Birds is shit.
They're awful. There's a bit where it looks like somebody's just got a cardboard, just like a piece of cardboard that has birds painted on it, and they go like this. And
I think they probably did. Yeah, I think that's about as much as the visual effects reached to back in those days. Well, obviously, there are other films by Hitchcock. I'm a huge Hitchcock fan. I like things like Rear Window, Vertigo, North by Northwest. But one of his classics was a film called Rebecca, which was based on a sort of thriller by Daphne du Maurier, and it starred Laurence Olivier and Jane Fontaine. And what's weird about this is Netflix have remade it, but they've remade it with a director called Ben Wheatley. And Ben Wheatley made The Kill List. He made Sightseers, which is a really dark, twisted British comedy. He kind of came to prominence with really violent, visceral, stylish films. Yeah. And this is, there's a violent sort of theme to this, because it's the story of a woman who falls in love with a sort of smarmy, swami, sort of Armie Hammer in Monte Carlo, swishy kind of guy. Mm. And when she kind of moves in with him, it starts to unravel that perhaps something untoward had happened to his previous wife.
Ah.
So it's Armie Hammer opposite Lily Collins, is it, I think?
I love Armie Hammer.
Lily James, is she the one who was in...
She's awful in Yesterday.
Yesterday. Yeah,
she's
a bit...
also in Baby Driver. She's a bit of a hit and miss.
She's a bit of a hit and miss. This also stars Kristin Scott Thomas and Keeley Hawes as well. Mm. And Armie Hammer, we've loved Armie Hammer since...
Oh, I love him.
The Lone Ranger.
I have a fat crush on him.
Do you? He's so...
So is he.
Oh, and of course, Call Me By Your Name, yeah.
Lone Ranger, Call Me By Your Name.
Do you think he's so extraordinarily tall that he doesn't almost fit into widescreen shots?
He's very tall, but I don't know if it's also because he acts alongside smaller people.
Could be.
Or is he actually tall enough?
It's a genuinely difficult... I've always shot in widescreen whenever I've done any factual programming, and sometimes when you had a really tall... I once interviewed Rutger Hauer, who plays the replicant in Blade Runner. Yeah, you know, the one at the end who says, I dream of da-da-da. And he was so tall.
Yeah.
We struggled to actually get him in shot. It was really odd. I mean, so sometimes... And I sometimes think with Armie... He's a bit awkward in his performance sometimes because the cameraman doesn't know how to...
I don't agree with that.
It's a very literal description of him. Anyway, I loved him in Lone Ranger. I absolutely loved him. And you're right, he was great in Call Me By Your Name.
Mm.
Let's hope this is it. So this, for me, this is really odd that Ben Wheatley's gone for this, because although there's a sort of dark side to this, it's quite twee in a way for Ben Wheatley. He also did High Rise recently, a J.G. Ballard film. So let's check it out.
The terrace is for guests only.
Monsieur. The young lady will be joining me. What did you do?
I'm a lady's companion.
Like it.
Maxim de Winter. His wife died last year and is in dire need of company.
I'm Monsieur de Winter.
What are you doing?
Oh, you'll see.
This week, I'd like to never forget it.
Come to Mandalay. I'm asking you to marry me, you little fool. Mrs. De Winter, may I present Mrs. Danvers?
Welcome to Mandalay.
Never seen a house like this.
Oh, I'm sorry, I thought you'd been a lady's maid.
This is all very new to me.
Oh, I'm sure you won't disappoint him, madam, if that's your concern. We did a lot of entertaining when the late Mrs. De Winter was alive.
You can talk to me about her.
I have no secrets from you.
All marriages have their secrets.
Has Max ever talked to you about the accident?
I don't know what you're talking about.
How am I supposed to know anything if you don't tell me?
She's still here. Can you feel her?
I'm tossing and turning all night.
Andrew. She was the love of his life.
I wonder what she's thinking about you. Taking her husband. Using her name. He doesn't love you.
I said I want the truth.
You didn't know her. Nobody did.
You can't go on living in that big old house with her ghost!
don't believe in ghosts.
It's going to sound really stupid, but the music ruined that trailer for me completely.
Right at the beginning. Who is it?
No, I don't know, but it's just that kind of like poppy... Like, it just ruined
it's overly sincere.
Like a good alternative.
Right.
Like, you know those good trailers which are like, doom, doom, doom.
Yeah.
If it was something like that, I feel like the trailer would have been better, but it just made the trailer...
I felt they had to go for that because they were sort of in Monaco or Saint-Tropez. I have to say, I'm really confused by the concept of this. I'm really confused.
It started off very different to how it ended up, that trailer.
Yes, yeah. I mean, Kristin Scott Thomas is always good, so I think she's a solid element. She's the woman who's in the house, who's very, austere.
Yeah.
Then it was nudging towards Ghost. Then you're thinking, why is Ben Wheatley, who specialises in sort of violence, aggression... and really twisted shit. This doesn't look that twisted.
No.
It just looks like a pretty straightforward man's killed wife. And I'm not saying that's good or normal.
No.
But it's not dramatic anymore in today's world, is it really?
Well, it's dramatic, but it's not enough to make a film dark and...
That's my point.
But also, it would be if it was done well, but it doesn't look like that's done well.
It's weird. I just can't understand.
It was weird. It felt like three different films in a trailer.
It did, didn't it?
I feel like the trailer might have failed itself. Like, I feel like the film might be... And Lily James doesn't look bad in it.
She doesn't look bad, though. I do feel that often she's presented in a place where she's chasing whoever she's acting alongside, talking to.
She's very twee characters.
Yes, I know what you mean. Did you see what I mean about Armie, though? He's very tall, isn't he, in every shot? I mean, everyone's reaching up and looking up and standing up. And the director's quite short, too, so all the cameras are looking up, too. Anyway, here's the thing. I wouldn't mind if it was a film, say, about the house. Maybe the house is a personality, but...
They needed to pick something to focus on.
You're so right.
Didn't know if it was like a horror.
A romance.
Yeah.
I don't understand the point. Guys, tell us.
I might see it just to see if the film
is
different to the trailer, though. Yeah. I feel like it's a bad trailer.
Fair point. Bad trailer. What do you think, guys? That's generous. That's being generous.
For more film and family fun, don't forget to click the subscribe button and make sure to click the bell to never miss an update.